Hi, this is Aileen from Materialise Belgium. In this tutorial video, we'll talk about the cutting options in Magics. Sometimes, the parts you want to print may be too big for your machine. In this case, you can cut your parts into smaller pieces, print these pieces separately, and assemble them afterwards. Magics offers a wide range of options from simple cuts to advanced cut profiles. Let's get cutting. We'll click on Cut or Punch from the Tools ribbon and start with the polyline option. For this option, all you need to do is define a polyline to cut through. Let's click on Apply. And let's translate our half. And here is our cut. Let's go back a few steps. You can also draw intricate lines with the polyline option. If you'd like to round up the corners of this line, you can enable round polyline. If you'd like to leave space for the glue you're going to use for reassembly, you can also enable clearance. The clearance may be on the inside, the outside, and both sides of the cut line. Let's click on Apply. And here is our custom cut. Let's go back a few steps again. In order to facilitate reassembly, you can also add teeth to your polyline. Let's add a polyline first, then click on Select Teeth Lines, click on the line, and in this menu, you can choose between teeth type, you can round up the teeth, you can change the size, you can flip the teeth, and you can even play with the offset to make sure that the edges of your part do not get an off tooth. Apply, OK, and click on Apply. And here is a perfectly good teeth cut. Let's go back a few steps again. For more advanced cuts, you can use the options under the Section tab. Here, you need to use the Multi-section option under the View Pages. Let's define a cross-section first. The basic option will apply a standard cut through the defined section. Let's click on Apply. Hide the multi-section. And here is our section cut. Let's go back a few steps. The left joint cut will create an L-shaped cut profile, either through the section contour or on a part of the contour only. Let's start with the complete contour option. Here's our section again. We highlight our contour and click on Apply. Let's hide the multi-section for a moment and translate this half. As you see here, one half is a protrusion, while the other half is an engraving. This makes it much easier to assemble your parts afterwards. Let's go back a few steps again. And let's try the 2 points option. In this case, we will click on 2 points, and then we need to specify 2 points on the contour where we would like to have the lap joint cut. Let's click on apply. Let's make some space and look at our cut profile. As you see, now part of the contour has this protrusion between the 2 points that I've selected, and on the other side of the part there is a bit of an engraving where this protrusion can fit in. Let's go back a few steps again. The last but not the least, Magics also has a pins and holes option. Here, your part will be cut and pins will be created on one face, while holes where the pins can go in will be created on the other face. Let's create a multi-section again. And let's click on apply. Let's hide the multi-section and move one half. As you see, on one side there are holes created, while on the other side there are pins to go into these holes. With this, you can very easily put your parts back together after printing. Thank you for watching, and please make sure you check our other tutorial videos. For further questions about our software, please don't hesitate to contact the support line of your nearest Materialise office.